As some of you may know, I'm not too happy with the way the 21st century is turning out. But rather than just sit around and whine, I've decided to ignore it, unplug it, and go back to 19th century France, where I belong. Here are a few scenes from my upcoming movie about painting with my favorite ghosts. I call this part visiting Renoir and trying to make a good impression on an impressionist.
This is Renoir's most sacred place. This is his studio. From 1907 to 1919, this is where he created his paintings. Because Renoir was so famous when he died, they left it exactly the way it was when he lived here. His brushes are still in the turpentine. His wheelchair is still waiting by his easel, expecting his imminent return. The room is quiet, but it has some of his favorite things here.
I kept thinking, what would it have been like if I was here 100 years ago? Since there were no cars back then, I probably would have had to walk a long distance. And I'd be startled when the sheepdog Zaza started barking to alert the family of a visitor. I could only hope I'd be invited in, cleaned up and fed. It would be the Grand Louise, their cook, who would warn me, "Monsieur Renoir does not like to talk about painting." And only then would I be led upstairs to the studio to meet the master.
"Bonjour, monsieur. Would you mind if I watched?"
"Anyone can look over my materials or watch how I paint. I have no secrets. Where are you from?"
"Well, would you believe I walked all the way from America?"
"Don't be foolish."
"Well, I was just kidding, but maybe we could talk about painting."
"I'll be happy to talk, but not about painting. Nowadays, they want to explain everything. But if they could explain a picture, it wouldn't be art."
"I don't mean to be rude, but it looks really painful for you to paint now that the arthritis has taken your hands. How do you deal with the pain?"
"Pain passes, but beauty endures. I am perfectly happy and will not die until I have completed my masterpiece."
"Well, if it's any consolation to you, 100 years from now, your paintings are going to burst off the canvas like you just made them. I know there's some secret. What's the secret?"
"Paint with la joie, with the same joy that you would make love to a woman."
"When you're making one of these works of unbelievable beauty, in your mind, are you really making love to the model with each brushstroke?"
"You know, I feel sorry for men who are always running after a woman. I've known painters who never did any good work, because instead of painting their models, they seduced them."
"What, in your opinion, makes a good painting?"
"For myself, I like the sort of painting which makes me want to stroll in it, if it's a landscape or if it's a female figure, to run my hand over a breast."
"You know, you have been so cool, I mean, especially for a ghost. You get me inspired. I want to like grab my brushes and run outside and start painting again."
"You should try painting in my garden. Good luck, young man. Actually, now that I look closer, you're not so young. You're old. Get out there and do it now while you still can. Use your legs and hands and brick before time betrays you."
"So now I'm going to go out in his garden and I'm going to paint what Renoir saw, paint it in the spirit of Renoir and try to use his colors and try to give you the feeling of what it was like to be Renoir and be here painting."
I searched for the perfect inspiration, I wondered which view was the master's magic place. Each one was spectacular. Finally, the ghost seemed to beckon me towards these two massively twisted olive trees.
Let's begin the way Renoir would begin. Now, he'd begin with a lot of very tentative, little washed out strokes to try to sort of set up what the overall composition would be.
I summoned the spirit. I said to the old man, "What is it that I have to learn?" And the ghost said,
"Why should an art be pretty? There are enough unpleasant things in the world without us producing even more."
Now, one of the great innovations of the Impressionists was when they saw a shadow, the shadow wasn't just black or brown, but the shadow could be navy blue or it could contain purple. In the same way, when Renoir saw the highlights on these olive trees, he could bring in orange or yellow or colors that more evoked than depicted.
Talk about a dream come true. There I was, painting in Renoir's garden, battling the same light, the same sun, and the same wind that had vexed the old man. Battling with my own painting, with the colors, with the lines, would it be good enough? Wondering if I could ever capture anything nearly as brilliant and breathtaking as nature. When is a painting finished? There's a moment when a painting can be anything you want in the world, and there's a moment where it's just going to be what it is. Do I really think Renoir's spirit guided me that day? Oh, why not? Time passes, but inspiration endures.